Hello friends, I welcome you all to this course Certification in Quantity Surveying, and we are dealing with the quantity calculation for the reinforcement. And let us go in a detail to calculate the quantity of the beam. So let us first of all understand what are the various things that have been provided to us, and based on that how to calculate the quantity of the reinforcement. So the first one, the size of the beam given to be 300 by 500 mm. The clear span is 4000. Clear span is the end-to-end distance between the columns for the beam. So this is the distance starting from the column's inner side to the column's other inner side. That's a total distance is the clear span. Then the stirrups that have been provided in a two phases by the structural engineer. At the ends, they are spaced at a closed distance of 200 center to center of bar dia 8. Then at the center, they are placed at a 400 center to center with the same bar dia. Then the anchor bar we have are those which we are providing at the top of the beam. They are of two numbers and 12 mm dia. The bent up bars are those which we are going to provide for the better distribution and expected transfer of the loads. So these are the type of bent up bar we have, whose dia is 16 mm and they are provided in two numbers. Then we have the clear cover to be 25 mm from all the sides. Then the development length is given 50 into diameter of bar. Development length is a extra length entered from for the beam, into the for the beam bar reinforcement for into the column. That this extra one that has been going inside is a development length. So next, let us see what exactly we are going to calculate for this one. So we need to calculate the cutting length of main bar, crank bar and anchor bars. Okay, and whatever the numbers we have are already provided, that is anchor bar in two numbers, the main bars in two numbers, and the bender bars in also two numbers. Okay, then we need to calculate the length of the stirrup and the number of stirrups also. Then ultimately we'll calculate the total length, total weight of the steel. So now let us understand what are the various types of bars we need to deal with. The first one is a crank-up bar. That is, this is the type of shape that is this bar is going to have. Then we have the anchor bars and we have the main bars. Anchor bars are inverted U and the main bars look like a U. Then we have the stirrup, which has been provided shown in the section XX and YY. Now why we are showing these two sections? Because the bent up bar or crank bar is having the bend at near to the end of the beam, so that it moves from the bottom of the beam towards the top. So now when I take a section at the XX, that is near center of the beam, the bent up bar is at the bottom. Then when I take a section at the near end of the beam, the bent up bar is at the top. So these are the two bent up bars which are moving from bottom to top. Then let us go for calculating the quantity of one by one. Let's start itself with the bent up bar only. So as we have learned that this is the kind of bar, bent up bar looks like, and suppose this is the beam a clear span end, and over here the beam's clear span end. So this is the clear span, that is the end to end distance we know. Okay, so that plus this development length on both the side, and there is certain extra distance is going to be added because of the bend, right? That 45 degree bend is going to add some extra distance. So that much I would just need to add, and out of which the value of these bends I need to deduct. So how many bends we have is a 90 degree bends, there are two, and there are 45 degree bends, 1, 2, 3, and 4. In total there are 4 45 degree bends. Okay, so this is how we are going to calculate. The first one will be the clear span, that is from end to end dimensions of the beam, plus 2 into 0.42 h. Now let us understand what is h. The h is shown over here. Okay, how to calculate the value of h? To and better understand, let us go back to the shape of the bar. So now this is how the cranking bar looks. So when I said that we are going to add, first of all, the total horizontal distance, that is clear span from end to end, but that is not enough because of this 45 degree bend that we have given to the bar, there is certain extra distance going to be added. Because when I say this is the distance horizontal, and same points if I connect in a vertically, okay, this, so obviously this distance is lesser than this distance because there is certain extra distance is going to get added, and that is what the distance we need to calculate. So that So now what is h? The formula says that this distance, extra distance that gets added because of the bend is 0.42 h. Okay, so now what exactly is the h? H is the distance between the center of the bar to the center of this bar. Okay, so the same bar center from at the top and at the bottom, whatever is this distance, that distance is called to be h. Mm-hmm. So this is what we need to calculate first. So now what is h? The center of bar from the center of bar. So that means if I want to show it over here, this is the center of this bar and ultimately this is the center of the same bar at the bottom. This is the distance. So now how can I calculate that? So I can take the total depth of the beam, okay, out of which I can minus the two side covers on both the sides, then half bar from this side I can deduct and half bar from this side I can deduct. So ultimately one bar dia I need to deduct. So the formula for h becomes to be h is equal to the total beam depth minus two side covers top and bottom minus one dia bar. That value comes out to be 4.34 mm. Okay, so I got the value of h. Now to calculate how this 0.42 h came into existence, so let us first of all learn that. Okay, so when I say this is the extra whatever the distance is going to get added, that's a 0.42 h. So let us first of all understand, see how it came. Okay, so when I want to draw the same triangle, so suppose this is the same bar I have drawn. Okay, so this is the distance that we already have calculated is h. Okay, then we say that this is a 90 degree, as we have taken a perpendicular for understanding, and these are the 45 degree bends that are given to the bar. So this is actually this is the bar, then this is the bar and this is our understandings for calculation. So now when I say this is a 45 degree bend is given, so the triangle becomes 45 45 90 triangle, out of which one length is known to us, that is h. Now with the property of the 45 45 90 triangle, or any triangle who has a two similar angles and one angle, the third any angle, the obviously the lengths of the those triangle of in front of the similar angles becomes the same. So if this is h, this is also going to be h. So now these both are h. Okay, so I can calculate the length of this bar actually. Okay, with the help of Pythagoras, that comes to be square root of h square plus h square. That is equal to root 2 into h. That is the value of this length. Now we know that value of root 2 is 1.414, that is 42 for our consideration we took, into h. Okay, so if I want to write it down, can I write this as a 1h plus 0.42h? Yeah, the same one. Okay, so now we have taken already this distance as a clear span, right? Out of which 1h, that is of this triangle, just relate this triangle over here, out of which this 1h I have already added for my calculation in a clear span itself. So now what is left is only this much distance, out of which, so means if I overlap this length over here, this is how it is going to be h up to here. So now what exactly this extra left is 0.42 h. so now this is how that formula came up. So the length of the crank bar comes out to be clear span plus 2 into 0.42 h, as we have discussed now, then plus 2 into development length. Development length is after the end of this beam clear span, whatever the extra distance beam is going to have for the proper anchorage into the column, that's the development length, minus bends. So how many bends we have? We have two 90 degree bends with us on either side and four 45 degree bends we have on two to either side. So that comes, I put all the values into this one. And development length is a 50d, that is already been given. What is the value of 90 degree bend as a 2d? What is the value of 45 degree bend as a 1d? Then the value comes out to be 5.837 meter for the bent up bar. And the number of bent up bars are 1, 2 over here. So let us go for calculating the length of the anchor bar. So now the anchor bars are at the top of the beam over here, they are provided. So now how to calculate the length of the anchor bar? Again, the same one. I said you clear span first of all, then we need to add these two development lengths into that. So one development length from here, another development length from here. There are two development lengths we are going to add. Then minus two bends, 90 degree bend from this side and 90 degree bend from this side. So in total, 2 into 2 into 12, that is the dia of this bar, anchor bar. So the value comes out to be 5.152 meter. Then the next one we are going to calculate the length of the main bars. So now again the main bar shape is like this. U at the bottom, they are, these are the main bars. Okay, so they are two number 16 mm dia. So there is no difference between the calculation of the main bar and the anchor bar. Only difference will be the value of D will change. For D for main bar is 16 and D for anchor bar is 12. That's only different. The same formula, the same values will put up. Only the value will change because of D, that is this one. Okay, then let us go for calculating the cutting length of. Now the another important one is the stirrup. So let us calculate the value of the, that one. So now what, how to calculate that? That first of all, we need to know the formula. Cutting length of one stirrup is equal to 2 into A plus B plus hook length into 2 minus bends. Okay, so let us understand what is what. So now what is A? A is the end-to-end distance between the stirrups horizontally. For my consideration, you can have in either way, no issues. And B is the end-to-end distance vertically between the stirrups, okay, stirrup lengths. That is A is equal to, so how am I going to calculate that distance? So A is over here. A is equal to horizontal total distance, that is 300, okay, that is 300 minus two sided covers. I need to minus cover from this side, cover from this side, and then the bar dia on either side, bar dia from this side and bar dia from this side. So that is 2 into bar dia that we have put up. The value of the cover is given to be 25. So the value comes for the A to be 234 mm. Now for B, similar for in a similar way, cover from both the sides out of 500, then bar dia from both the side out of 500. So that value comes out to be 434 mm. Then let's put the values in this formula. That is a cutting length of one stirrup is equal to 2 into A plus B. A is equal to 234, B is equal to 434 plus 2 into bar dia. 2 into hook length. The hook length value is a 10 into D that we have in standardly, we use that. That is a 10 D minus how many bends we have is a 1, 2 and 3 90 degree bends we have. That is a 3 into 2 D. That is a 90 degree bends value. So that comes to be 1.448 meter. So now we have calculated the length of the stirrup. We need to calculate the number of stirrups also. So now as you can see, the number of stirrups are given into two different spacings. So I have defined this corners one as a zone one and the center zone as a zone two, because at zone one the spacing is 200 and at zone two the spacing is 400. So let us go for that. So number of stirrups in a zone one, that is a left and right, that ultimately left and right I can say, that is a length which has been given to be 1600 divided by spacing, which is 200 plus 1. The length comes to be 4, total number comes to be 4. Therefore, the total number of stirrups in a zone 1 will be here 4 and here 4, total number of 8 numbers of stirrups will be there. And the number of lateral ties on the stirrups on a zone 2, that is over here, will be equal to length divided by spacing. Now, the length is equal to 2800 given over here, divided by spacing, that is 400 over here. Now why I have taken a minus 1? Because we already have added plus 1 into this formula. That is one stirrup been already added and that has been multiplied by 2. So extra stirrup is getting added. So I am going to minus this stirrup, one from this one. That is equal to the formula coming out to be, the value coming out to be 6.1. Okay. So now the total number of stirrups will be the summation of these two. So now let us put these values together. So I have a crank bar. The shape of the bar is like this. Dia of the bar, as we know, the 16 mm. The number of bars are 2 for crank bar, anchor bar and main bar, both of them are 2. The diameters are put over here. Now the cutting length that we have calculated, we are just going to put them together. Then with the multiplication of these two, I'm going to get the value of total lengths that we need to have. To those total lengths, if I just multiply with the unit weight of bar, that's a d square by 162. D is in mm, it's a dia of bar. We calculated, we have these values, so we just multiply them. we get the total weights of the bars. In case of stirrups, I just added the total number of stirrups in a zone 1 and zone 2 together, that is coming to be 6 and 8, 14. The cutting length that I calculated, so multiplication of these two will give me the total weight of the bars. So we have added them together, and with the help of we just need to add some wastage into that, that's a 3%. The total value of the weight coming to be 54.969 kg. And this is how, and this is the most important, you know, chart over here. So that explains everything, that what is the name of the bar, how it the shape is, and what are the numbers and unit weight and everything. So this, only with the help of this, you know, page, we can have the proper understanding of the whole bar bending. So this is our aim, to create this page. Well, this is where most of the time on site it has been created on an Excel sheet, but for your understanding I've been dealing with this one. Okay, so with this, I wish you all the best. Thank you so much.